While claiming that it has absolutely nothing to do with Donald Trump, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi and Congressman Jamie Raskin, who's been on the program several times, introduced a bill today to form a commission that would rule on the president's fitness for office in order to, quote, enable Congress to help ensure effective and uninterrupted leadership in the presidency. This is being called the Commission on Presidential Capacity to Discharge the Powers and Duties of Office. And it would be the body and process called for the 25th Amendment to the US Constitution. So what does that mean, the body that would do that? So the 25th Amendment, which has been talked about a lot in the past few years, though probably not enough, provides the procedure for the vice president to take over the duties of the president in case of his death, resignation, or inability to perform his duties. But specifically, the amendment says that when the vice president and a majority either of cabinet officials or of such other body as Congress may by law provide determine that the president's unable to discharge blah blah blah, then the vice president shall take over the duties of president. So that body hasn't really been defined. Hypothetically, it could have just been Congress itself, but they're saying this will be the body that the Constitution is specifically talking about, and it's not about Trump. Nancy Pelosi says not about Trump. He'll face the judgment of voters. But he shows the need to create a process for future presidents. Well, she's talking about setting a precedent there. Brett, what do you think about this? The politics of it right now and how it might play out long term.
So there's two videos that you can pull from. One is her teasing that she's gonna be talking about the 25th Amendment, which is quite powerful and amazing. And like she's in the middle of talking about stimulus. She's like, by the way, come back tomorrow because we're gonna be talking about the 25th Amendment. Thank you. All right. Just gonna leave it there and I'm gonna go back to stimulus. Today was she literally says civics lesson, and I wanted to pound my head against a table. And I love Congressman Raskin. He goes through like the specifics of it, and they keep saying stuff like, they keep going like, this is not about the president. But what is missing from it is video of Nancy Pelosi, and she needs to create this, of her saying in a way that is very obviously sarcastic, saying, listen, this isn't about the president. You know, we didn't think of it until the president made such crazy, illogical decisions based on potentially being incapacitated by a steroid that he admitted to being on, which we know causes psychosis. We looked around and said, you know what? It turns out we don't have any protocol for anything this wildly unprecedented. Mm-hmm. We don't know. That's why the 25th Amendment happened after Kennedy was shot. There was no way to replace the vice president after that. We needed something to come in. But then they get so into the weeds. I'm very grateful that that despite their inability to generate something that is that replayable, the media has picked up on why they did it, which is president's a little over the top. He's made some wildly terrible decisions because of what I just said. And I think that Pelosi's trying to troll him pretty hard right now and just remind people and do play some offense to say the president is not capable of being president. He's also putting everyone in the line of succession at risk. So we got to reevaluate at this point.
Yeah. It was definitely a great opportunity. Like, it's, you know, just want to be very clear, it's not because the president was on Fox News last night saying that California dumps water in the ocean to save little fishies. It's not that. It's not that. And you could just go through a litany of all the crazy things that he said. It's not because he talks about windmills giving you cancer and does this little thing where he goes, wee. It's not about that.
30 times in a row yesterday.
Exactly. You could do all that. But anyway, on the actual substance of this, look, we do need to have a procedure for the 25th Amendment. That said, I don't like this. I like Jamie Raskin. Jamie Raskin's a pretty good congressman. Him being involved in it sways me a little bit. And by the way, he's been consistent about this. This is not the first time that he's brought this up. He's worked on it in the past. In 2017, he did. Now, granted, that's still Trump times, but I don't like the idea that something like this could be set up in the future to try to like say that Obama wore a tan suit, so he's clearly crazy. Like, I don't trust it. Having the cabinet be the ones who make the decision means that in reality it'll never happen. But that at least seems to fit in with what the Constitution is trying to get at least. I don't want some future, you know, I don't want the Republican House to decide that President AOC wore a lipstick that was too bright, so we gotta get rid of her.
Yeah.
And that is how I feel like this ends up going.
I agree. I had the same thought. For some reason, I thought about like, when gunpowder was invented, it was for fireworks. You know, it was to make the sky pretty, and that's Democrats. We're gonna do this thing, and the only thing I can think of right now is it makes the sky pretty. And Republicans are like, how can I shoot stuff with it? How? And that's exactly, exactly what's gonna happen with this commission.
Yeah.
Which won't pass and won't carry over into the next thing. They'll abandon it. But that's why I think the idea is great to tell people, like, to try to, and it feels like they're doing an impression of McConnell, which is like, you know, there's processes in place that we're just following. Mm-hmm. Or like, there's nothing in here, whatever. But it doesn't have that. I am very, you know, it isn't obvious enough what conclusions people should draw from it just by looking at it on its face. That's the same criticism I have for people on the left with terms like defund the police and versus the way that the Republicans are able to come up with things that are very easily digestible without seeming offensive on their face.
Yeah. Yeah. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.